SAFM.
And Brad Brown will come to you shortly, but we just want to speak to Mzukisi Kota about the ANC and their decision not to amend or change Section 25 of the Constitution as it relates to the expropriation without compensation bill. Mzukisi, thanks so much for speaking to us this afternoon.
Thank you very much for having me, Sakina. It's a pleasure to be on you. Sure.
So it's very interesting, the ANC now saying that they've decided not to amend or change Section 25 of the Constitution. And in your analysis, I think quite compellingly, you actually start by making the argument that as the public, we actually don't know much. And it was from the very onset rather unclear as to what the meaning and ambit of Parliament's adoption of that particular bill was actually was. So just speak to us briefly about that.
Absolutely. I mean, I think it's actually apparent from the outcome of this land summit that the ANC itself was very unclear on what they were trying to achieve, and they're now starting to do some of the thinking that should probably have been done before the motion was put before Parliament. But I think they found themselves basically backed into a corner there. And so the motion itself is quite broad, and it's some type of compromise position between very aggressive stance wanted by the EFF and the ANC trying to claw back some of this ground and bring this to, a bit more to a center grounding. But the result of that is that it is very difficult to get a sense from the motion of what exactly is this potential amendment to Section 25 of the Constitution going to look like. And just on that note, Sakina, I'm not as confident as you that they've actually said they will not be amending Section 25 of the Constitution. I just thought I would flag that point.
Fair enough. Because as we've seen, I mean, this was also unprecedented for the ANC to do the sort of consultative work and allowing outsiders into their deliberations on the matter, which of course shows that they haven't finally made up their minds on this matter on how to proceed as well.
Agreed. And I think that's probably the most positive thing from, I guess, sitting as a lawyer and I think from a general public is actually the fact that the ANC seems to have opened its mind. They're approaching this whole constitutional review process with an open mind as to whether even the question of whether an amendment is required. And that's what I think is really the most significant thing coming out of their communications today, that they're open-minded as to whether there might actually be mechanisms that government has failed to really try and investigate and use in Section 25 for its transformative potential, rather than rushing to say it needs to be amended. So that, I think, is really very welcome for anyone who's been a bit concerned as to what this means and what does it look like. Not just the principle of expropriation without compensation, but what an amendment to Section 25 of the Constitution means and what it means in relation to the balancing exercise required by the Constitution. And also some of the rhetoric that people have been very worried about, that Section 25 of the Constitution is, in fact, the biggest hurdle to land redistribution and land transformation. So the ANC seems to actually be, through consulting broadly and not just within the ANC, be taking those aspects of the resolution quite seriously. That, you know, you'll remember that President Ramaphosa, when he gave the State of the Nation, spoke about how whatever the future land redistribution or land tenure looks like, it must be done with broad-based consultation. And that came across again in the EFF's own resolution that they put forward. And it's great to see that actually being taken on board by the ANC within its own processes before they even get to their own NEC and actually welcoming a broader participation group.
So just a final question. Is the Constitution as it currently stands a hindrance in addressing the land issue? Because you also grapple with this in your analysis, asking whether there's a crisis regarding this land question.
So, I mean, on that point, I think, as the Lamula, Mr. Ronald Lamula, correctly points out, there is a difficulty in Section 25(2)(b) with the idea of expropriating without compensation. It might be possible in certain limited circumstances to do that, but generally, I think if they're going to go on an aggressive expropriation without compensation, they are going to run into some constitutional difficulties if they have it as a general principle. But he did point out some instances which are probably good cases, such as where there are labor tenants who currently live on a piece of farm anyway, that no one can argue that that is being used for other commercial purposes. So expropriating that piece of land that the farm dweller currently has their homestead on and they currently live on and use without compensation would seem to be probably a good test case for where I know that I'll probably come under a lot of criticism for saying that. But I think that these are probably good test cases to see how far can they push this policy within the limits of the existing Section 25. But it is primarily, I mean, some of the things he's mentioned, like the case before the SCA, that case is about the failure of the government department to protect labor tenants. So a lot of what was coming across this weekend, even from Khalima Mantlante's statements, is about government's own failures. And now they seem to be saying, okay, fine, we're going to take this seriously, and we're going to try and see what we can do as government within the existing framework. But we are still looking in the constitutional review process. We're going to look to see the extent to which that requirement to pay compensation, albeit only just an equitable compensation as opposed to market-related compensation, whether that requirement creates limitations and how we basically loosen those limitations within that requirement. That is still very much on the cards from his speech.
Mzukisi Kota, I suspect we will be speaking quite a bit more as this particular story unfolds. And that was the director of Herbert Smith Freehills, Mzukisi Kota, who wrote a brief analysis on the motion adopted by Parliament.